Hello guys, and welcome back. When I started in this hobby, one of the most intimidating things to me to overcome was changing the battery plug on your battery. Sometimes we don't have the option when we buy the battery to come with the correct lead. As you can see on some of these batteries, we have different types and different sizes, and depending on our quadcopters, we may need to change them. And my case in point is I need to put this XT30 connector on this 2-cell LiPo here. So in this video today, I'm going to show you how to do that the safest way I can. Stay tuned. Okay, so what we're going to need for this project, and I'm going to start with one of the things that I think is probably overlooked and most important, is a solder tip cleaner. If you do not have one of these, and if you're going to spend any time in this hobby learning how to solder, definitely get you one of these. They're like less than $10, so invest in one. They make a world of difference. The next most important thing that I use when I'm soldering is flux. This is some rosin core liquid solder flux that comes with a hypodermic needle, so you can easily spot where you want to put your solder at, and it also flows into the wires of the solder that you're trying to solder a lot easier. You're also going to need some rosin core solder. This solder that I use is from SAR Soldering Products, and it is the 6337 clean core. Okay, you're also going to need your battery, of course, your battery connector that you're going to change to, a set of helping hands. I got these from Hobby King. They were like $8. It's one of those must-haves. Or you can also use some of that build tack, you know, the sticky stuff, Play-Doh stuff that you put on the back of a poster and stick it to a wall. I don't have none of that. I used every bit of it that I had up because it dried out on me. A pair of scissors or a hobby knife to cut your heat shrink tubing that you need. A butane torch. I like the butane torch because a lighter, a regular cigarette lighter, leaves that black soot everywhere. And a heat gun works really good. If you have a really small one that comes with a soldering station, that would probably work, but I don't have one of those. A regular big heat gun, it's really hard to control your heat that you put onto your heat shrink tubing, and I'll show you my technique why I use this, because it's really pinpoint where you can put the heat at to shrink the tubing. You will also need some strippers, and these are some flush cutters that I got at Walmart for like $4.95, and these things are awesome for cutting zip ties, because it cuts them right off at the top of the zip tie and you don't have a little sharp point stuck out. And one of the things that you'll need to be cautious of, no matter what soldering iron you use, is the size of tip you use. This one here is one of my smallest ones, and that's what I use to solder some of the small ports or solder pads on to flight controllers. But today we're going to be using a slightly larger one, this one here. And this is what I use when I'm doing anything bigger than 16, 18 gauge. When I start messing with 12 gauge or 14 gauge, I start using the bigger tip soldering iron because it's a lot easier to transfer your heat into what you're soldering. Okay, so I'm going to get set up here and I will be right back here in just a moment. Okay, to get started here, the first thing we're going to do when we get ready to do this, what you want to do is you only want to cut one lead at a time. It doesn't matter which one you want to start with. The main key thing here is only cut one lead at a time, so we don't have an accident to where these leads, you're messing with the leads and they actually bump together. You can imagine what will happen if two leads get stuck together with a real high C discharge battery. This is just a 30C2 LiPo, but if you can imagine if you're messing with a 4C or a 5C battery, if the leads touch and they won't come apart, how quickly this wire will get hot, and you're basically going to have a fire. So the first thing we're going to do is we're just going to take and cut one of these leads off the plug with these flush cutters here. And I'm just going to reach in just snip it off just like that. And then I'll take my strippers here and strip a small portion of the insulation bag. And I'm just going to twist these wires. And I'm going to demonstrate why I like to use flux on everything I solder, whether you're tinning it for the first time, even though the solder here has flux in it. I've found that using liquid flux, like I said before, flows into the wire, and the solder just wants to wick it up so much easier. And I'm going to demonstrate that. This first one here I'm going to do, I'm going to just only use the soldering iron and the solder to try to flow the solder into the wire. So I'm going to start by putting a small amount on my iron because it helps transfer the heat better. So I'm just going to put the soldering iron on the wire, and then I'm just going to flow the wire into it like this. And you can see how long it's taking. If I can get the camera to focus. And it looks kind of, see how I'm getting all the stringy stuff behind here? And it's not really soaking into the wire. That's because I've ran out of flux. The flux is the key to getting solder to flow. And all I'm gonna do is I'm gonna come in here and I'm just gonna drip just a little bit of flux right on top of this. Just a drip. And then watch how quickly it takes. There, you see how it sucked into the wire almost immediately, and the wire is starting to become shiny, because shiny is what we want. Let me go ahead and add just a little bit more solder to it. Make sure we got plenty in it, because what you're going to want is for it to look like that, shiny all the way around it. Okay, so now that we have that, we are going to grab the XT30 connector, and on this particular connector, the tabs are bent. Turned. One's facing this way, the other one's facing that way. What I like to do is I like to take a pair of pliers or these cutters and just reach in here and spin this around to where both of these are up here on top. Just like that. And then I'm going to use my helping hands here to hold the connector like that. And just like before, you could use your soldering iron to flow the solder in here without flux, but I've gotten so used to just putting flux on there, everything just flows and works better for me. I don't know if it's just me or just the way I've gotten used to soldering over the years. Okay, so now that I get my soldering iron over here, I'm just going to put a little bit on it and just kind of flow it down into the battery connector to where it looks just like that. Let me see if we can zoom in and get just a little bit better demonstration of that. Just take it and flow it right in like that. Okay, now nice and shiny. That's what we want to see. To be nice and shiny like that. Okay, so now what we're going to do is before we solder this on, we want to cut us a length of heat shrink tubing. And I like to put this on after I've tinned the wire, because the wire heats up and then you end up getting, especially if you're dealing with a shorter piece of wire, your heat shrink tubing ends up shrinking on the wire back here, and then you have difficulties getting it up here where you want. So I'm going to slide this on and all the way down that I can. And also, this is an opportunity. This isn't going into quadcopter. It's actually a battery pack that I'm going to use to power my module on my Tyrannus. And so I want the longer leads on it. But this is an opportunity where you can cut down your leads too, even if you're not changing. If you are changing your connectors, you have the opportunity to shorten those. And one of the other things that I like to do is I like to take just a marker, a felt tip marker, and mark the negative side. Just to keep a clear mind, visual. I always like having visuals to make sure that I don't solder the positive on the negative side, because that would be a bad day. So I'm going to clamp this in here. And I'm going to solder on this side of it. So I'm going to turn this a little bit so I can reach it slightly better. So we can zoom in on it. Clean my tip, and on the same thing before, I'm going to go ahead and add just a little bit of flux, and it doesn't take a lot, just a drip on here, because we've already burned up the flux after we tend it. There's not much flux back, but we're going to add just a little bit. Like I said, that just helps getting everything to flow in there real nice and easy. Let's see if I can get this to where I can solder this on, and I'm just going to lay this right on top of this. And this is the bad thing about this, what I'm doing right at the moment, is 14 gauge wire on an XT30 connector, it's kind of tight. There's not much of room here on the connector to solder this to, but I'm just going to lay it right over the top of it, just like that, get comfortable with it. And if you have to hold this with pliers because it gets too hot, you can, but I've been doing this for a while. And we're just going to lay the soldering iron right on top of it. And we're just going to wait after we touched it to make sure it cools, because you don't want to move too soon if you don't want to have any cold solder joints or solder joints that have pulled apart as they were cooling when you move. And what you're going to be looking for when you check this is you want to see that your solder is nice and shiny and is flowed into the connector nicely. I think I'm going to put just a little bit more solder on my tip and put just a little bit more heat on that just to make sure. I think it looks okay. On the bottom there is kind of questionable. So I'm going to put just a little bit on my tip here and hold everything down, and I'm just going to lay it right on top of it for just a couple more seconds. Let it cool off. Check it again. There, now you can see how, wipe some of that flux off of there. You can see how well the solder is kind of blended into the connector itself. Okay. So now that we got that, we're going to go ahead and slide our heat shrink tubing up. And this is where I like having a butane torch, because it is a pinpoint where you can put the heat. You can see this tube doesn't quite want to fit in this connector that well. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my torch here, and I'm just going to hit it right here on the edge. Just click it. And you can see how I shrunk up that right here, so that way when I slide it up, I can slide it right inside of that connector. That way I've got it all the way up inside that connector I want. And then also, instead of just full blasting like this on it, I can pulse this, and I can control exactly where my heat is while I'm doing this, so that I'm not burning up my heat shrink tubing, because you can burn a hole right through it if you're not careful. So there we go. There's our positive lead that is connected. So now we're going to do our negative. So on the negative one, we're just going to take our flush cutters here, and we're going to just kind of line up with where we had cut it before, so that way the wire lengths look about the same. So we'll cut that completely off. And then we'll take our strippers, same process, take our strippers, strip a short piece of the insulation back. I'm going to twist the end of the wires together. And then on this one, I'm going to show you when I put flux on the wire first, how quick it takes the solder, because the flux is going to be soaked into the wire. A little bit more like that. Okay, now I'm going to start with a clean tip using my tip cleaner. Same process though, I'm going to put a bit of solder on my tip because it flows into the wire better. And you'll watch, just as soon as I touch this wire, that the solder is going to actually soak up into the wire. You can see it just sucking right off the tip. And all we got to do is just add the solder to the wire, because the heat is transferred so much quickly to the wire itself, because the with the flux being inside the wire, it made it so much easier for the solder to soak into the strands of the wire with the flux. And as you can see, that just soaks all the way to the back. You see how much quicker that was, and how much cleaner, how much more shinier that is than what it was before. So that's why I like using flux, because over the years I've realized that flux is the trick to getting solder to flow. I mean, without the flux, it just isn't going to work. At least that's been my experience. Okay, so now we'll go ahead and put our heat shrink tubing on. Don't forget to put that on, because it's a bugger when you have to unsolder a wire that you did a really good job on. Slide it all the way to the back. I'm going to clamp our connector into my helping hands here. Get everything positioned. And just like before, I'm going to put just a small amount of solder, or I'm sorry, flux, on both pads, because it makes it flow easier. I know I'm saying that a lot, but I'm trying to get to the point that it makes a big difference. So I'll put a small amount of solder on my tip. I'm going to lay it right on top of the lead, just like that. Let's see if we can get a little better shot. Of doing this. And move to that frame. There we go. So I'm just going to put it right on the top of it. About 5 seconds or so. And you see how the solder kind of, you can see when it cooled off, when the sheen changed on it. So we'll go ahead and clamp it. And we'll inspect our solder joint here. I'm going to wipe it off with a rag that I've got here. Okay, so we'll take a closer look, and as you can see, the solder is real shiny, and it's almost look like it's melted into the gold part of this connector. And that's what you're after. That's how you know you've got a good solder joint. Okay, so now all we lack is putting our heat shrink tubing on. And this is where, again, the butane torch comes in handy. I can just hit it a couple times there on the very edge of it, shrink it up, and then I can just slide it right into the connector all the way as far as it'll go inside there. I may have to hit this back corner right there so I can slide it in there. I know I've got it all the way in when my heat shrink is at the same length, because I cut them exactly the same length with some scissors. And that's why I like using scissors, because I can hold two pieces together and clip them off that way they're the same length. And then we'll just take the butane torch here and kind of shrink our tubing. Okay, and there we go. We are done. We've got our XT30 connector soldered onto the lead of my 2S LiPo, and that's how easy it is and the safest way I know how to do it. I hope you found this helpful, and I'll see you in the next one.